In the last video, we discussed the direction field. The direction field is made of arrows with slope equal to the derivative of the dependent variables. These arrows show the path of the time evolution of the dependent variable. We also learned about the steady state. At a steady state, the derivative of the dependent variable is zero. Take the example of the ODE given here. This ODE has two steady states, x equal to 0 and x equal to 1. Once the system is at a steady state, it will not change with time. Suppose at t equal to 5, x is at 1, a steady state. Now we disturb it from this steady state. Suppose I forcefully pull it up and then allow the system to evolve with time. From the arrows on the direction field, we know that after some time, x will come back to x equal to 1, the steady state. The same will happen if we reduce x from 1 to something lower. Therefore, x equal to 1 is such a steady state that if we perturb the system from this steady state with time, it will return back to the same steady state. We call this steady state a stable steady state. Now check the behavior around the other steady state, x equal to 0. If I pull down x to a lower value, with time x will move away from x equal to 0. The same will happen if I change x to a slightly higher value. X equal to 0 is called unstable steady state. For an unstable steady state, if we perturb the system from the steady state with time, the system will diverge away from the steady state. I have shown the behavior around these two steady states by drawing trajectories in the direction field. If you start just above x equal to 0 with time, x will reach 1 as that is the stable steady state. There can be another type of steady state. Check this direction field. X equal to minus 1 is a steady state. If we start above it, x will diverge away from this steady state. However, if we start below minus 1, with time, x will converge to this steady state. So from one side, the system reaches the steady state. From the other, it moves away from the steady state. This type of steady state is called a semi-stable steady state. Here is a question for you. I have drawn a direction field. This has three steady states. Check the arrows and identify the stabilities of these three steady states. You can identify the stability of steady states even without drawing the complete direction field. You can use a shortcut. Let's try that for this ODE. We will first check the stability of the steady state at x equal to 1. Draw a table like this. Now take x equal to 1. At x equal to 1, dx dt is 0. So we draw a horizontal arrow. Now take a slightly higher value of x, say x equal to 1.1. For x equal to 1.1, dx dt is minus 0.11. As the derivative is negative, x will decrease with time. So we draw a downward arrow. Now take a value slightly lower than the steady state. For x equal to 0.9, dx dt is positive. So with time, x will increase. We draw an arrow pointing up. Both the arrows above and below the steady state are pointing towards each other. So this steady state is a stable steady state. I have done the same analysis for the other steady state, x equal to 0. Here both the arrows are moving away from the steady state. Therefore, x equal to 0 is unstable. All the rules for stability analysis using this method are shown here. Note that the steady state must be in the middle row. The higher value of x must be in the top row and the lower value of x must be in the lower row. Changing this order will mess up your calculations. There is another way to identify the stability of a steady state using differentiation. Suppose the ODE is dx dt is equal to f of x and the steady state is xss. Calculate the double derivative of x at that steady state. In other words, calculate the derivative of the right hand side function at that steady state. If this derivative is negative, the steady state is stable. If this derivative is positive, the steady state is unstable. Here are the key points of this lecture. For an one-dimensional system, steady states are of three types: stable, unstable, semi-stable. Stability decides the time evolution of a system around a steady state. If we perturb a system from its stable steady state with time, the system will return to the stable steady state. You can identify the stability using direction field or by using calculus. That's all for this lecture. Thank you.